He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay guys, for today's problem, we've got this epoxide, and we are going to react with methoxide in methanol, and we're going to get this product. So what we need to do is show the mechanism. If this is confusing, you're going to want to take a look at my lecture on epoxides, and then give this a shot. Okay guys, so to draw this mechanism, we have to recall a couple things about epoxides. Number one, epoxides are very susceptible to nucleophilic attack because there's a lot of ring strain from that small three-membered ring. That means that either of these carbons could potentially be attacked by a nucleophile. So we do have a nucleophile. We've got methoxide. That's going to be a good nucleophile. So we want to ask ourselves, which carbon is it going to attack in the epoxide? Now, sterics are going to dictate that it is going to go over here. It is the less sterically hindered side. So it is more available for nucleophilic attack. So if it attacks right there and it's going to pop open this epoxide, we're going to get this here. So this is the methoxide that attacked. This used to be the epoxide here, but now that popped open. So we have the oxyanion there. And now the second step here is kind of like the second step of a Williamson ether synthesis, except that it's intramolecular, because this oxyanion can do an SN2 right here and kick off this bromide, and that'll lead us to the product. And so what we can do, just to make sure we're able to draw that properly, we can see that this is going to create a five-membered ring, because this oxyanion is going to attack this carbon, so that generates this five-membered ring, and then this group over here will still be there. So there we go. We have an opening of the epoxide followed by intramolecular ring closure. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.